Hey, what's up? Welcome to Italian Time. Check your clocks. What's up, guys? I'm Brian. This video, we're gonna be talking about 6 must-know Italian words that are so common, so used. They're quick expressions that you should use too when you're speaking Italian. The first one is basta. Basta is one of the most common words in Italian, and it means that's it. If you're making a long explanation of something, at the end you'd be like, e basta. Another way to say it, basta così, and that way, it ends. Basta literally comes from the verb bastare, which means to be sufficient or to be enough. So when you say basta, you are saying like, that's sufficient, it's sufficient. So that's how they say that's it. Another meaning of basta is when someone's annoying you and you just say basta, like stop, that's it, that's enough. Stop right there, okay? Word number 2 is mi serve, which means I need. Literally, it means like, to me, this thing serves. So you have to be careful with that pronoun. It could be mi serve, ti serve, gli serve, le serve, etc. But strangely, in Italian, they don't really have a verb to say like, I need something. If it's I need to do something, dovere is the verb. But if you need something, an object, you usually will use mi serve. So random example, I need a phone, mi serve un telefono. Similar to piacere, when there's something plural, you have to change serve to servono. So if you have 2 of something, I need 2 phones, you'd say mi servono 2 telefoni. I need 2 phones. If you want to say she needs 3 apples, I don't know why, le servono 3 mele. The third word is volentieri, which kind of means I'd be happy to, or I would do this happily. For example, if someone asks a favor of you, you can respond and say volentieri, I'd be happy to. Volunteeringly, I would do it, volentieri. Or even if someone makes an offer for you, would you like some caffè, vorresti un caffè, you could say volentieri. Like, sure, that'd be a pleasure, I'd be happy to. Volentieri. Think about voluntarily, that's kind of what that means, but volentieri, great word. Word number 4 is prego, which comes from pregare, which means to pray or to beg. But prego means go ahead, or continue, or after you, you first, please take this. So if you come into my office and I say prego, it means take a seat, sit down, go ahead. If we both start talking at the exact same moment, I say prego, it means go ahead, you can start. So it's in English, actually, we're missing this kind of expression. Prego is very useful to politely say you can go first, or please take a seat, or after you, etc. Prego also is the formal way to say you're welcome after someone says grazie. The 5th word on this list, which is probably my favorite, is mi va. Similar to mi serve, that pronoun could change. So it could be ti va, or le va, or li va, or mi va. It means are you down, or do you feel like doing something, or are you up for it? So if I say, why did you do that? The answer could be, perché mi andava. So remember, va is coming from andare. So if I put andare in the imperfetto tense, mi andava, it makes sense. It means because I felt like it, it went for me. Literally, I felt like it, I wanted to, mi andava. Or if you say, I don't want to, you could say, non mi va. Like, that doesn't work for me, I don't feel like it, non mi va. Or if I want to ask you, do you want some ice cream? Ti va un po' di gelato. This expression is super useful, I highly encourage you to use it. And remember, in the past tense, it will be andava. In the present tense, va. Mi va, mi andava. Last word in this video is a question, which is che c'è. Che c'è literally means what's there. It's an Italian way to say what's up, what's going on, or also what's wrong if said in a sad intonation. So if I see you and you have a very sad face, I could come in and say che c'è, which means what's wrong. If someone's like Brian, I could say si che c'è, like yeah, what's up, tell me, go ahead, che c'è, what's up. And that is the end of this list. If you guys like this video, please give us a like and consider subscribing if you like our videos. If you want to support Italian Time, we have our Patreon page where you will have access to lots of exercises, including listening, reading, speaking, writing exercises. That's super useful. So let's wrap up here, guys. It was a pleasure, and I'll see you next Italian Time. Peace.